Hello, and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for on-site training, code reviews, and contracting. Now, this is the fourth episode in our series on learning modern C++ by using the tools that are available to you effectively, and we are in Visual Studio. I suggest that you go back and listen to episodes 1 and 2 for how we got the setup for this and why we are using Visual Studio. And in this episode, I'm just going to pick up where we last left off, and I'm going to talk about const and constexpr a little bit, and we're going to see what other tools can tell us about that. Now, in the last episode, we had our derived and base, and this is all ended up becoming rather complicated to do everything correctly. And that was by following the rules that our tidy, clang tidy was giving back to us, which was great. It helped us get all the gotchas. But we also have this unique pointer here, and if you are an astute observer, you may have noticed that I did not use make unique. That is partially on purpose. Part of the problem is that I was creating a derived and returning a base object, which is one reason why clang tidy didn't catch it for us. But the other thing is that I'm really was just trying to steer you away from using heap allocations, because this is not something that we like to do. If we keep things on the stack, the compiler can optimize it better, and that's better. So we have this thing, and we realize it's pretty much over-engineered. So let's just go ahead and flatten this all out. We don't have any need for this. We have our data member, and we have our do thing, and we will put the do thing here, and we'll get rid of this. And you can see all along the way that the compiler is telling us what we have done wrong very quickly. IntelliSense is here from Visual Studio. We have something that's override that doesn't override, so we'll get rid of that. And then we have this thing that is called derived that doesn't exist anymore, so now we have type. And let's just go ahead and give this a slightly more meaningful name. So we've got our object, and we're calling our function on it. Now, let's go ahead and run this through clang tidy and cvp check and see what we get. I'm going to go ahead and remove that line. And this is some of the areas where cpp check really shines compared to other functions. It has this do thing can be made a static function, and this is a very interesting comment. It says making a function static can bring a performance benefit since there's no this instance. So it is entirely correct. Since this is not operating on any member data, we can just make this static, and that's still going to compile exactly the same, and the compiler may be able to do more efficient things with it because it knows that it doesn't need to care about the this pointer. But let's say that this is maybe not fair. What we really wanted to do for this do thing is return our current data value plus 4, something like this, just to make use of our local data. And so we're not modifying anything, we're just doing this. And we will rerun this now with cpp check. And now cpp check is telling us making this function const is what we want to do. And that's right, that's good. We should make all of our member functions const when possible. And so this is great. It's teaching us to use const where we should, and to use static when possible. So let's add our do other thing. And just for the sake of testing here, let's see if clang tidy gives us any other information. So there's no warnings from clang tidy, but one thing that we can learn here that our tools are not yet able to teach us is that this really could be constexpr. And there's no reason to not make this function constexpr. All of our data types in our structure currently are trivial, and this can work. So we have just done that, and maybe this is one of those things where the tools cannot yet teach us what we need to be doing to write our code as good as possible. So we've got our object type, and we've made our members constexpr and const, and now let's call them. And we're going to do that with argc. So we say if argc is greater than 1, we call do thing, and otherwise we call do other thing. So we'll go ahead and run this through CPP check again and see if it teaches us anything else. So let's see what CPP check tells us. And we have here that CPP check says it has found the same code in if and the related else block. This is suspicious, might be a cut and paste or logic error. And wow, that's great. It really was. We really meant to call do other thing. So CPP check caught that for us. Now, we realize actually what we didn't mean to do here for this code was to call it in the case that argc was greater than 1. Let's go ahead and satisfy our tools like this. What we meant to say is if the size of long is greater than 4. So in this case, we're saying effectively, is long a 64-bit or a 32-bit in this code? Let's see what our tools can give us for this. So for this one, we are going to go ahead and build our solution with Visual Studio. And now we have this warning that was recently added in Visual Studio that says conditional expression is constant. Consider using if constexpr statement instead. So out of curiosity, let's see if our other tools can catch this. So this warning here is the one that is still from Visual Studio. We can tell because it says C4127, that's its code. And this one is the one that is coming from Clang Tidy. And it just says consider replacing long with int32. So that's, well, if we replaced long with int32, then we know that it would never be greater than 4, and we're trying to test something out here. So if we make this if constexpr, then we can satisfy Visual Studio, and it's the only tool that I'm aware of right now that will tell us when things could be a constant expression in an if constexpr kind of way. And this is helpful because it is actually guaranteed to only compile the given block of code if the constant expression is true, instead of if it's a regular if, then it's something that is almost certainly compiled away, but not 100% guaranteed to be. So that wraps up our episode for now, as far as what our tools can teach us about our const members and using if constexpr and constexpr members. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.